I'm glad to meet you in the knowledge sharing program. The title of my presentation is Korea's 98% reduction in child traffic fatalities, policies and achievements. I'm Jaewon Seol, an Emeritus Research Fellow and former Vice President of the Korea Transport Institute. This is the contents of my presentation. First, Chapter 1, Introduction. Chapter 2, Statistics of Child Traffic Accidents. And the Child Safety Policies, one by one. Road Safety Regulations for Children. Road Safety Education for Children. School Zone Improvement Projects. Operation of School Buses. And finally, Child Safety Support Groups. Now, Chapter 1, Introduction. This presentation is the revision of the book Korea's 95% Reduction in Child Traffic Fatalities, Policies and Achievements in 2014 by the Korea Transport Institute. There was 3% more reduction of child traffic fatalities after 2014, and now total 98% reduction. I am the editor of this book, and this is the book. This slide shows the reduction of child traffic fatalities in Korea. The number of child fatalities in 1988 was 1,766, and it has been reduced to 28 in 2019. And there was total 98% reduction in child traffic fatalities during 31 years. This slide explains the successful measures for child safety in Korea. In the engineering field, school zone improvement, school bus regulations. In enforcement, double penalty to the school zone violations, strong criminal punishment to the child accident drivers. In education, compulsory safety education at the schools. In encouragement, child safety support group activities. Now let me tell you about these policies one by one. Chapter 2, Statistics of Child Traffic Accidents. This table shows the trend of child traffic accidents in Korea. The total number of traffic fatalities decreased from 11,563 in 1988 to 3,349 in 2019, about 71% reduction. During the same period, the number of child fatalities reduced from 1,766 in 1988 to 28 in 2019, about 98% reduction. This table shows child fatalities by time of day. About 71% of child fatalities, total 20 deaths, occurred between 12 and 20 during afternoon travel. The most dangerous time is between 18 and 20 during the after-school and dusk hours. This table shows child fatalities by road user type. About 65% of child fatalities were pedestrians and 20% were car passengers. Motorcycle fatalities were only 3%. This table shows change of children population. The population of children under 14 years old decreased from 12 million in 1985 to 6.6 million in 2019, about 46% reduction during 34 years. And it became nearly half. As a result, the protection of children became very important to all parents and government in Korea. This is one of the important backgrounds of the strong children protection policy in Korea. This graph shows proportion of child traffic deaths among OECD member countries. Korea recorded the fourth lowest country in 2011 and 13 in the proportion of children under 14 years old in IRTAD member countries, and the figure is 0.8% in 2019. Now, Chapter 3, Road Safety Regulations for Children. In Korea, road safety regulations for children have been strengthened continually by various acts. Road Traffic Act, Traffic Accident Management Special Act, Motor Vehicle Management Act, and Transportation Safety Act. First, Road Traffic Act. Article 11 of the Road Traffic Act stipulates the duties of police officers and motor vehicle drivers to protect the children from road accidents. The detailed contents are in the box below. This slide shows double fines and double points for school zone violations. The violating drivers in school zones should pay double fines and get double penalty points. This slide shows protection of school bus on the road. When any school bus stops and operates its yellow warning light, the motor vehicle drivers in the same lane or the lane beside it should stop before reaching the bus to protect the children. This slide shows double fine for child restraint violation. The penalty for general seatbelt violation is about $27, but the penalty for child safety seat violation is about $54, double fine. This slide shows criminal punishment for school zone accident drivers by Traffic Accident Management Special Act. The driver who causes a child accident in the school zone should be prosecuted and punished criminally. The penalty is minimum 3 years imprisonment for fatal accident and minimum 1 year imprisonment or $26,000 fine for the injury accident. This slide shows child seatbelt regulations by Motor Vehicle Management Act. This act stipulates the safety standards of school buses, including the seatbelt and car seat regulations. This slide shows Child Transportation Safety Plan by Transportation Safety Act. This act stipulates the establishment of National Transportation Safety Master Plan every 5 years, including the Child Safety Plan. Now, Chapter 4, Road Safety Education for Children. This slide shows compulsory safety education by Child Welfare Act. Under provisions of the Child Welfare Act, all kindergartens and elementary, middle, and high schools are required to implement road safety education of minimum 10 hours a year. The detailed contents are in the box below. This table shows legal hours of safety education by Child Welfare Act. The road traffic safety education is minimum 10 hours every year. This table shows subjects of traffic safety education by Child Welfare Act. The subjects include understanding of road facilities, safe road crossing method, and others. This slide explains about the traffic safety teacher in every school. By the instruction of the Ministry of Education, one traffic safety teacher for safety education should be designated among the teachers in every kindergarten and primary schools. This slide shows about the practical training at traffic parks. There are total 66 traffic parks nationwide, and about 257,000 children were trained at the traffic park in 2018. This slide shows an example of traffic park in Goyang City. Entrance of traffic park guide map, and general view. These photos show education facilities in the traffic park, education for road traffic signs, education at signal crossing, education at no signal crossing, and education by accident example. Now, chapter 5, school zone improvement project. This table shows designation of school zones for all schools. The Article 12 of the Road Traffic Act stipulates that the areas within 300 meter radius, 500 meter when necessary, from the main gate of kindergartens and elementary schools are designated as the school zones and the speed restriction is less than 30 kilometers per hour. The detailed contents are in the box below. This slide explains about the guidelines for school zones. Under the Road Traffic Act, the guidelines for school zones is made and applied by the Ministry of the Interior and Safety, together with Ministry of Land, Infrastructure and Transport, and the National Police Agency. This slide shows procedure of school zone improvement. The first step is application of designation, and the last step is monitoring. This slide explains about traffic safety facilities in school zones. In school zones, roadways and sidewalks should be installed, and also road signs, speed humps, safety fence, and other facilities. This slide shows examples of school zone facilities in Pungsan Elementary School in Goyang City, including a large school zone sign. These photos show traffic safety facilities in school zones, guard fence, speed limit, road hump, and red color surface. These photos show the combined traffic signs, including school zone sign and speed limit sign, school zone sign and speed hump sign, school zone sign and towing area sign. These photos show the beginning point of school zone, including school zone sign and pavement markings. This slide shows the example of basic design of school zone in Seoul, including traffic signs and pavement markings. This table shows school zone improvement works achievements. As of the end of 2018, school zones were designated at 16,765 locations in the whole country, and construction work had been completed at 11,801 zones, about 70%. This slide explains about the half subsidy of school zone improvement cost. The average cost of school zone construction work is about $63,000 for each zone, and the Ministry of the Interior and Safety gives half of the cost to the local government. This slide shows before and after comparison of school zone improvement project. After improvement, there are footpaths, no parking, pedestrian fence, speed restriction, speed hump, and school zone markings. Now, chapter 6, operation of school buses. This slide explains about school bus registration in Korea. There are about 64,000 school buses for children. The school buses should be registered to the MORIT, Ministry of Land, Infrastructure and Transport, for the motor vehicle control, and also registered to the police for the driver and operation control. This infographic shows school bus safety requirements. The safety requirements of school bus are including body color yellow, child protection signs, stop signs, roof warning lights, seat belts, backing sound, etc., as you see in the infographic. These photos show example of school buses: front view, rear view, stop sign, and school van. This slide shows duties of school bus operators and drivers. School bus operators and drivers are required to receive periodical education according to the Road Traffic Act and also observe various safety regulations related to the vehicle operation. This photo shows examples of safe school bus operation. The assistant teacher should care a child when getting on and getting off the school bus in order to prevent the child from road accidents. This table shows duties of car drivers around school buses. All drivers around school bus are required to abide by special regulations for the protection of children on school buses. Now, Chapter 7, Child Safety Support Groups, Civic Activities. This slide shows major support groups for child safety in Korea. Korea Green Mothers Association is a non-profit volunteer organization founded in 1971, about 530,000 members nationwide, mostly mothers of elementary school children. Citizens Coalition for Safety is a non-profit organization with about 20,000 members, and Korea Child Safety Foundation and Safe Kids Korea is a branch organization of the Safe Kids in the United States. This slide explains about activities of support groups, safe school travel, instructor training and school education, operation of a walking school bus, and proposals on traffic safety policy for children. This slide explains about organizing the Mothers Association. In 1971, the National Police Agency ordered each police station to organize the Mothers Association in every primary school and to cope with the association for the child safety in the region. Two Green Mothers are designated in every class in every primary school, and there are total 530,000 members nationwide. This photo shows the activities of Safe Road Crossing Guard by the members of Mothers Association. This photo shows traffic safety campaign by the Mothers Association together with the children. This slide shows the summary of child safety policies and child traffic fatalities. You can see the continuing decrease of child traffic fatalities along with the child safety policies. This slide shows the final suggestions. Strengthening road safety regulations for children is no cost, most effective, and most important. Road safety education for children is low cost, most essential, and long-term effects. School zone improvement project is very effective but high cost. School bus operation is very effective but high cost. Mothers group activities are low cost, very effective, strong supporters for child safety, and number one priority. Begin with the children and it will be successful. Thank you very much for your attention.